Hey guys, we are here chilling at home. There have been a dad, super dad, yeah, giving back in the morning to the family. In the evening, he's gonna go back to work.
He's there to work, and I work a lot. Guys, normally I would have 2 days of the week. We have to be up at 4 o'clock because training starts at 6 a.m. And then I have to go back in the evening for another session, so I have double sessions on Sundays. Even the kids are asking me if we can stop.
Yeah, the boys, they always come home and be like, so daddy gonna come home today earlier? I was like, no, nothing about it.
Yeah, because when I leave in the morning, they're sleeping. And when they come home in the evening, they don't come home at night.
Yeah,
so
that's true.
The boys are not used to that at all. Because all their life, daddy has been home. So they're adjusting. But I'm gonna like it.
Since you like it.
You mean I get the most of it though?
Yeah.
She's always home.
Yeah, sleeping peacefully. And that's the position she sleeps the most during the daytime. She doesn't really like to go in her bassinet in the daytime. In the nighttime she sleeps very good in it. But in the daytime she just wants to stay either on chest. Either she just don't want to sleep, so that's the thing. But personally, I'm afraid to put her on the belly to sleep in the bassinet because they say like it can lead to SIDS, them call it the syndrome, that when the infants die suddenly because they can turn. Yeah, if you. Yeah, sometimes because them still can turn head, and she can turn her head straight in a mattress. Oh, and sometimes, right, but sometimes them don't know how to turn it back, you know. And then they suffocate and they die suddenly in them sleep, which you don't want that. All right, so we just there. I'm gonna grab breakfast while Errol with Miller. Yeah, because mama got to do some things next. Yeah, my hands will be well full. All right. So, good morning, guys. I'm going to show you a little piece of our daily routine. What me and my newborn, she's not really newborn anymore, you know. She already like 2 months born. Yeah, but she's still baby. Me and my baby, we go through from day to day. And I don't complain enough. I just pray to God, give me more patience. How you doing? You alright? Right now, I don't press baby clothes anymore. But first 2 months, them I did press. But I still wash it separately from all our laundry. And I still wash it with a baby soap. Alright? No harsh chemicals. But I'm just done with pressing. I'm done with pressing, and I googled it. I googled, said to me it's all right to not press baby clothes. I mean, are they gonna look more organized if you are going to press them, and they're gonna be a little bit more softer. Yeah, so some materials, you know, some materials are still press them because they're very harsh when you don't press them. But normal cottons, them body suits, I stopped press them, and I decided I'm gonna give myself a little rest. Yeah, and I tested out Miller, she all right, no allergy. So me quit pressing. I just wash them, okay, spread them for dry. When they dry, I pick them up and I fold them pretty. Yeah, me now stress myself where it's not really necessary. So what y'all think, guys? How long did you press your newborn baby clothes for? Me literally for 2 months. Yeah, and then I stop. But she alright though, no allergy, everything alright. Yeah, anyway, sooner or later, you're gonna stop wear super press clothes. Such a life, right? Only when you go out, you press your clothes, right? Well, when I press my clothes when I'm in the house. My clothes are my red. I will look for me. I will look for me, Mila. Eh? Only daddy and 2 brothers, but them understand. Yeah, man? Yeah. Yeah. So, we're good, but we do good. We're doing good. Yeah. So Mila is right now more active. She stays up longer. She sleeps less in the daytime. She has very long sleep. I'm glad for that long sleep. So she goes to sleep maybe at 1 o'clock after lunch. And then she wakes up about 5 when kids they come home. So this is so perfect for me. It helps me to do some house stuff, and it helps me as well to give myself rest. Okay, yeah, and the time is just, you know, perfect, well balanced. So I don't feel really stressed out, and I don't feel really tired. And yes, I have a little sore cold, because in the night I still have to wake up. Sometimes I change diaper. Sometimes I, most of the times, every time I breastfeed. Yes. So sometimes I change diaper, but breastfeeding is a must. When she cries, it's a breast. Yeah, it's a breast issue. She wants my breast. She wants breast milk. Yeah. But I don't really like to keep her in a diaper for the whole night. Yeah, because after six hours, I usually feel diaper. And most of the times, diaper is well puffy. Yeah, even though she does not really do in the night, because a couple of nights I notice, like since last week, she kind of stopped really doo-doo. Like it happens sometimes. Before it happened every time, so I had to change diapers a lot during nighttime. But this week she kind of slowed down with defecating in her diaper. So most of the times it's just her pee in the diaper. Yeah, pee full of the diaper. But I still don't like to keep her for long, even though we sleep with the AC and it's cool, it's not so hot. So it's minimum risk when it comes to diaper rash. But I still, and I use diaper cream as well, but I still do change her. In the night I try to change her. In the daytime it's more regular, because she do do in the daytime. Yeah, and I don't want to keep her, even when the diaper is not super puffy. When I feel she let it out really strongly, I always check it out. And if it is what it is, I always change her. And my thing in the daytime, I do not use wet wipes, because I'm at home all day. Yes, on the road, wet wipes. But when I'm at home, I always try to carry her and put her under the water and wash her with water, her private parts with water. Not all of the baby I bathe with water in the daytime. No, we take bath maybe once in 2 days. But my pediatrician recommended me even every day, don't worry. But since we're at home most of the times, we don't go on the road, I'm like, all right, I don't think it's a big deal for me to be there like every single day. And also as well, I test her sometimes. If she pull up pukes them, I bed her. If she not pull up pukes them, I bed really her. Yeah, me just give her like a wipe, I will go sleep. But once in 2 days is a must. I know some even parents bed babies once in 3-4 days. But me no want to go to the extreme level. Yeah, me not go to the extreme level. We gotta do what we gotta do. Yes, Mila, you do good. So I feel like I have to take out my play rug. Yeah, do something with baga toys, because right now she can see things very good and she likes to see things. And you know why? This bed, she really loves this bed, because see this? This is a ceiling fan. And when I spin it, right now the AC at work, so I'm gonna spin it. But when I spin it, it can occupy her for a good while of time. Maybe for about 20 minutes good. Yeah, so I have a play mat for her. And I think it's time for me to take it out. Yeah guys, and as well, we went to see our pediatrician just the other week. It was our 6 weeks visit after our very first pediatrician checkup in the hospital. Yep, because they don't check you out of the hospital without pediatrician checkup. Yeah, well, you can check out but at your own risk. All right, you can sign some papers, but you don't want something to happen, so better you wait in the hospital, wait till be able to do the PP, and wait for the hospital pediatrician, then you're good to go, not earlier. Okay, yeah. So the other day, a lot of people in the comment section, they were telling me to clean my baby mouth, and I was cleaning my baby mouth, but she still had extremely white tongue, like something was on her tongue, white, and I couldn't get rid of it. So when we went to our pediatrician, it ended up to be the same lady from hospital. She good enough, yeah. And I asked her about everything, so she told me Mila has a little infection, a little fungus, them say, so I have to treat her with the special syrup she gave me, and I have to give her like 4 milliliters a day, every day, yeah, to get rid of this thing. And I still have to continue cleaning her tongue. So it wasn't the matter like I did not clean the baby tongue, whatever the hell, you know, I'm not a bad mommy, yeah. And as well, she gave me some prescriptions, some vitamins. I totally forgot I have to supply baby with the vitamins as well, because I gave birth to my second child like 6 years ago. I do not remember. No. Yeah. And this, I got this from pharmacy through prescription from my pediatrician. She gave me iron drops. Are you familiar with it? Probably if you're from Jamaica, you know it, and you give it to your baby. And this thing they gave her for her white tongue and little fungus in her mouth, so I treat her with it, and it's pretty much for the little baby, like the dose, but so it's written, and that's how it is taken, I guess. But she don't like this. Yes, so right now I'm giving her this Tropivite FP, the brand. Another brand, you know, but good brand. So 05, I forgive her. Yeah, I'll show you how them blogger the show, so it give you guys focus. So it looks at the Jeep already. The Jeep already. Mother have a little rub, she always spit it out. Yeah, sometimes she spit it out, but this one she never really spit it out. Oh wait there. Oh, all right. Hey Mila, we have to take medicine. Come, you good? Yeah. Oh no, not all, baby. Yeah, and this one she don't like it. This one she don't like it. This one she don't like it, but it has cherry taste to it, flavored with some cherry flavor, artificial flavored. So I have to give her 1 milliliter 4 times a day. She don't like it, so that's it. Don't focus on here. It's how much I have to spray 0.5 in one cheek and 0.5 in another cheek. Yeah, so that's how they told me to do it. Oh, she spit it out like crazy. She don't like cherry. Jesus, what am I for do? So, Osh, Mom, come get you. Jesus. It's okay. See, my brothers came home. Osh, oh no. What's that, Danny? You got 90?
Yep.
Wow. I have a
sticker, but I only get one round. Oh. It's special.
Okay, then you will remember it next time, right? Okay. You got 100? I know you're gonna get 100. Is that a question? I know you're a super stella.
Mom, can you play Fortnite?
No, you are.
Mom, can you play Fortnite?
Okay, yeah, Mom, you deserve Fortnite. Huh?
The out of fantasy for 100.
Yes. Okay, so you got 100, right? Good job. I love puke a lot. No, it's crying. I'm gonna give her a bath. Wash. Fresh again, fresh again. Yeah, I had to be at her after that accident. Guys, the way I was afraid, it frightened me now. Yo, the way it made me nervous. I mean, that hurt me right now. The way me did afraid for she get choked upon her spit or whatever, burp. Oh my, oh my. So right now, so I get it together. You see them things? Them disappoint me and they make me nervous. But I'm third time mommy. Anyway, I still get nervous for my baby, okay? For Mila. Yeah, I was really afraid. Well, I gave a bath. Anyway, we have to move on. We have to move on from that. And right now, I'm going to lotion her with lavender lotion. And then a lot of people said to me, she'll go to sleep faster. From bathing to lotioning her with lavender scent. Because lavender works miracle. Yeah, the scent just relax you and put your mind in a good place. And me also need a lavender. Cause me too nervous right now. Me too anxious. I tell you, my anxiety level went up. But me fair, take it easy. So it goes. Yeah, see?
It smells so good.
Feel lavender in the air, Mila. See? Smell it. Amazing. Of course. So, gonna rub Mila a little bit. You know, not too hard. Not too hard. I'm not rubbing you hard. I'm rubbing you gentle. Made mommy really nervous. In your hands. And today I did not, and I probably will not get chance to sleep because kids are at home. They came from school early. Today was Heritage Day in school. That's what they did. Yes, Jamaica land we love. That's what they did at school today. They came home early, and that's why you saw they were wearing Jamaican t-shirts with Jamaican flags on them. Yeah, it's not their uniform, okay? It only happens on special days, Heritage Days, for example, today. Yeah, right now I'm going to feed kids, beat them, because they came from school well stinking off. Them man, them can be stink sometimes, yo. Yeah. I bought some Domino's pizza. I'm probably gonna grab something. Cause I need some energy. I just eat normal cheese pizza. Damn, it's already cold. So pizza gets cold fast. Second pack is for kids. They love pepperoni. Yeah, we kinda gave Pizza Hut a break. Cause them go too thick. Like it thinner. You see like Domino's? Yeah. So just the other day me I eat and be a dough me I eat. Yeah. We have to bush pizza.
Mm-hmm.
Bush pizza?
Mm-hmm.
And pizza? Now?
Da.
Okay. And for dessert, I'm gonna have guisada. I love it. Yo, you're having gamer meal.
Mm-hmm.
Like a real gamer. I said a gamer meal. That's how gamers eat.
Now with the broom. Look, yeah. There's a witch broom and I can play.
Boys just can't stop play. Then he came home
mama,
sick.
Mama, see that witch broom? I can play with it, mama. Watch. Look.
Hey, I totally forgot to tell non-Jamaican subscribers what this Heritage Day is. This holiday recognizes and celebrates the cultural wealth of the nation. So Jamaicans really love their culture, their roots, their heritage, and that's a good thing. I think as well, this event is important for Jamaican community abroad because it teaches Jamaican people a lot about them own a history, especially those Jamaicans who were not born in Jamaica, so they did not really experience how it is to live in Jamaica and grow up in Jamaica. You know, when your parents migrate a foreign, migrate to USA, Canada, and England, and then they give birth to their kids, that generation, them kinda already westernized generation, so they are more likely to lose their roots, you know, their Jamaican, Caribbean roots. So we got 3 days as well. Saturday free anyway, Sunday free anyway, and Monday, Jamaican people got Monday free. So the beach I got full, the fish I got fry, the bami I got fry, festival I got fry, alright. When it comes to my country, I don't remember people celebrating Heritage Day in Russia. People celebrate in Russia Day, when people dress up in the t-shirt with Russian flags and they, you know, drive cars with the Russian flag even outside, you know. But Heritage Day, I don't remember celebrating like Jamaican people do. But what I know, Russian diaspora in foreign countries, in US, Canada, they do have Russian Heritage Months when they represent to other people our culture, you know, when they represent to other people our food, our folk songs, dance, and a lot of traditional things. But growing up in Russia, I do not remember celebrating Heritage Day like here Jamaican people do.
What's up, guys? So right now everyone came from his workplace and today was a Heritage Day, so they celebrated it.
And Errol
did not come with empty hands. He brought me something, some traditional treats. Look, because Errol him not really eat sweets, so he carried it home and give me, because I do. Sometimes I drink tea and I eat something sweet.
Okay, we're gonna check it out with Leo. Leo, do you know what it is?
Blue grass.
Right. Also known as Taya leaf or Dukono.
Dukono.
Dukono. Street. Street number 2 is. What is this? Ghee. Gizarda. Yay! This is a gizarda, right? You are. Show me again. Made from freshly shaved or grated coconuts. It's a coconut thing. Coconut sweetie. Okay, pick up next one. Let's check out next one. And what's the name of it? Do you know? Do you know the name of this thing? It's a grated cake.
Grated cake.
Grated cake, right you are. The grated cake is a very sweet traditional dessert in Jamaica that should be consumed in moderation. What's moderation, Errol? What's moderation?
Moderation.
Then said should be consumed in moderation.
Not a lot.
Not a lot. Oh, oh, so you cannot eat a lot of this, Kayaga kids, diabetes.
At school, they were
selling. Oh, they sell it at school?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright, next thing. And this one? Yeah, coconut drops. Right. Coconut drops. Then anyway, you fart and run away. Slap, you know. We are working here, making video. Okay, and the last thing? Show me the last one. The last one? No.
Oh, I know.
See at the bottom? What's up? What's up with this? And this is what? Do you know the name of it?
Banana bread.
No, Leo, it's not a banana bread. Try again. How does it look to you? Like a
Purana?
Purana. I don't even know the word. Purana? No, it's not Purana, Leo.
It's not Purana?
No, man, it's not Purana.
Purana.
No.
I knew it would be Purana.
It looks like a pudding. It looks like a pudding, right? Pudding, of course. It looks like pudding. It's a sweet potato pudding. Sweet potato pudding made from sweet potato. If Jamaican people would celebrate, Halloween, that's what you would get at the door. That you would get at the door for Halloween, if Halloween would be a thing in Jamaica. But Jamaican people, them well Christians, so no Halloween a day. Jamaican people do not celebrate Halloween.